respectful coming up in this game and not thinking y'all just gonna take over what we've already been in. You're not jumping over nobody. You know, you're not jumping over nobody. This thing is like, it's like your age. I tell comics all the time, quit trying to get there so fast. Because Hollywood is very unforgiving.
It is.
You can get it and mess it up and can't get back in. You cannot get back in. It's like your age. You're 11 to you 12, you're 12 to you 13. You don't jump from 13 to 20. Why? There's some maturity that needs to happen. But some of y'all, if you got it before your time, you would fuck it up. You would fuck it up every single time. I love what Kevin Hart is doing. Every guy that's come up with him, all of his writers, whether they're working or not, he's got them on a payroll, they get a check every week, and he's got them with insurance, you know, and that's what we have to do. When you come up, bring somebody up with you.
A lot of people do not do that. So again, I truly applaud you.
You gotta have a make the landlord. You gotta have people. light that in your corner, that when those days get dark, you can call and say, "Man, I'm thinking about quitting. I just ain't pushing it." And they be like, "Yep, right." I remember one time, simply marvelous, she was my mentor. She's the first black woman to have an HBO special. And she called Joe Torre one day. She said, "I'm thinking about quitting." He said, "Good, yeah." That's Joe's friend. That's Joe's friend. He said, "Good, more room for me." But what it did was it motivated her to keep moving. Wow. You know, to keep going. And then she had some other health issues and she moved back to Baton Rouge and she's not doing. So very seldom do you see and have still yet to see a black female comedian on the level of a Dave Chappelle or a Cat or a Kevin Hart or a DL or any of them. Because what happened, we fall in love, we get a baby, so many war stories out of the US. He said, "You know, you female comedians, we'll see y'all for 4 or 5 years, then you leave, you go have a baby, you go, then you come back, I ain't seen you for 6 or 7 years, you be like, you're my baby." So we don't have that same, I'm not gonna say drive, but it's so many of us, we want that love, that's why we're on stage, we want that attention. This is a lonely business.
Yes,
you have to love you. And like I told Dr. Tom the other day, and I tell all y'all, you have to love this one. You have to love this doing comedy. You have to love it so much that if you could not do it, you would not.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to conclude this interview right here. You have to love it so much that you would be willing to die. And I tell you what, I truly thank you. Thank you. I thank all of you. I truly appreciate the opportunity to share this moment with you. It is a moment in time in history that will never be forgotten. We are here at the Laff House Philadelphia. This is Mrs. Make It Happen 215. You can see the footage online from Mr. Make It Happen. We thank you. We thank you, the host. We also want to thank Rule 107.9 tonight. We thank our former cameraman who had to leave us, but he was here as well. And we thank the Laff House of Philadelphia for bringing back comedians. And we thank everyone here. Thank you so much. And you'll see the footage soon. Thank you. Thank you.